गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. सो इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी स्टडीड अबाउट डिफरेंट जनरेशंस ऑफ कंप्यूटर. सो टुडे नो जस्ट टेक पेज नंबर 11. दिस पेज 11 वी विल स्टडी अबाउट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ कंप्यूटर. सो यू नो वॉट some special characteristics of computer are given. Today we are going to study that. So a computer system is better than human beings as it possesses the following capabilities. So here it is given why it is better than us. So of course there is some specialties, capabilities, that is why only computer is better than humans. So first one is speed. Speed is the amount of time taken by the computer in completing the task. Speed means in how much time the computer is performing its task or doing its work, that is known as speed. A computer works very fast and can do large number of calculations quickly as compared to a human being. So as compared to us, a computer can calculate things very easily. Like suppose we have two or three numbers, we have to calculate it or multiply it, we will take time. But computer can do that work in seconds only. Computers are classified on the basis of instructions that they execute per second. So as instructions we are giving to the system, like that only it is going to work. Next one is accuracy. Accuracy refers to the degree of perfection of operations performed by a computer. Computers do not commit errors and are capable of handling complex instructions accurately. If the data fed into a computer is wrong, it may produce an inaccurate result. So accuracy means, like suppose we have solved any numerical or any question, it is chances that question can be wrong or our answer can be wrong. But if the instructions which we are giving to the system is correct, then it is going to give us the result accurately. Means it is not going to give you results like false result, or if you are like suppose you enter two amount, the sum you get is accurate. Accurate means as suppose you put 2 plus 2, it will give 4 only. Suppose if you did not put the sign plus, or if you did not put the correct number, so it is not going to show the result. It is going to show inaccurate result, and there are no chance that it is going to be wrong. That is why, no, with the high speed it is also having accuracy. The next one is reliability. Reliability refers to the quality of a computer system as to perform it is very reliable. Like all the duty, no, which you are going to give to the computer system, it will do on time. Like suppose we are human, sometimes we forget, sometimes we are sick, anything can happen, no? But it is not happening with the computer. It is going to do the work on time only. So next one is well and completed is allow. See, suppose you understand reliable in the term. Suppose a work is given to us, some of are going to do it half an hour, some will do in 1 hour. Suppose some complete your homework in half an hour only, some will complete your homework in 1 hour. Some eat food fast, some eat food slow. But sometimes what happened, we do not do our work. What is our work? Sometimes we forget to do our work, whatever we have to do. But it is not in the term of computer. See, completes its allotted duties on time without experiencing any system failure. In case of any failure in a computer system, there is a provision for immediate backup of information and program. See, when it is completing its work on time, no, that time it is there is no failure. When sometime, you know, we are doing something, we fail in that. But what about computer? The work we give, it is going to do it, and on time also. If sometimes the computer cannot do it work, so there is an option for you have seen, like, suppose you are writing something and suddenly the power goes off. So if you have done something in settings, no, then of course automatically it is going to save. Sometimes if you lost your data, then if you are having backup, then you are going to get it again. But suppose we forget something, so we have to learn it again. Versatility. A computer can perform a variety of tasks. Therefore, it can be used in almost all fields such as education, science and technology, business, finance, accounts, communication, etc. Versatility means, like, you know, some are doctors, some are teachers, some are engineers, some are pilots. So in different field, people do their different work as per their interest. But a computer, no, it can be used for education also, by children, by teacher, by principal, by staff. Then it can be used in hospitals also, in banks also, in science and technology, for business also you can use, for finance and for accounts also you can use, for communications also we can use. So we can use this for many different tasks. Storage is the capacity of a computer to store data. A computer can store large amount of data which can be used anytime. See, what is storage? Just you have to underline this line. Storage is the capacity of a computer to store data. This first line you have to underline. See, the capacity of a computer to store data is known as storage. A computer is having so much large amount of storage. Suppose if you are having only like 12 GB storage, you can expand it. There is the option to expand also. You can store data into a computer through various external and internal devices such as hard disks, CDs or DVDs, pen drive, RAM, random access memory, ROM, read-only memory. A hard disk can store the maximum amount of data among these devices. The maximum amount of data that can be stored depends on the device chosen by the user. See, suppose you are having a computer, so you can use RAM, random access memory, ROM, read-only memory, pen drive also, CD, DVD, then hard disk, so many things you can use to store different type of data. So how much data we will have? Any amount of data we are having, no, we can store it. Among all these storage devices, a hard disk can store many, many data. In a very large amount, it can store data. But it depends on the user what we are using. Like, some are using CD, some are using DVD, some are using pen drive. Mostly we are using pen drive only. Those who have so much of work, they are only using this hard disk. So come to this page number 12. Diligence. Computers are non-respondent to human factors like fatigue, tiredness or boredom. It can work repeatedly and efficiently for long hours without taking rest. You know why nowadays robots are coming, now humans are not required? Why? It is so diligent, you know. See, it will not get tired, no boredom, no fatigue. Like we are doing some work, no, we get tired, we need rest. We can get fatigue, we can become ill also if we do the work continuously. We can become bored also by doing same work. But computer is not a living thing. It is not having feelings. It will not get tired, it will not get bored, it will not become weak. Without eating, without drinking, it can live. Only it needs energy. So nowadays, no, computers are coming. Always you have not to plug it, just charge it. It's work on battery. So it can work continuously without taking rest. So it is easy for us, so that our work can be done very fast. Next one is multitasking. A computer can do many tasks at the same time. For instance, one can enjoy listening to music while typing in MS Word or while working on any other package. See, multitasking means ek saath computer kai sare kaam kar sakta hai. Like suppose you are typing something, at the same time you can listen music also. Or you can do paint also. Many, you can operate Excel also. But it is not for us. See, if you are studying, you will study only. If you are cleaning, you will clean only. If you are cooking, you will cook only. So at one time we cannot do many things, but computer is a multitasker. So today we studied characteristics of computer: speed, accuracy, reliability, versatility, storage, diligence, and multitasking. These seven characteristics we studied. Then next we will study limitations of computer. What are its limitations? Incapability to think. A computer cannot think and take decisions on its own. In case of any error, it cannot take an alternative action. See, इतने सारे इसके characters होते हैं, फिर भी इसके कुछ limitations हैं. Limitations means see, it cannot think. It is incapable of thinking. So we say it incapability to think. Why incapability? See, anything, no, we have to give command, then only it is going to work. It is not going to work it on its own, because ye soch nahi sakta. That is a limitation. No intelligence. Unlike human being, a computer has no IQ. It need instruction at every step. See what happen, agar aap kisi ko jaisa jaisa bolo wo waisa waisa karta jaye, it means they have no brain of their own. So we are having brain, we are commanding the computer system. Computer is not having there on any IQ. But nowadays, you know, AI systems are there. AI means artificial intelligence. Like, you know, Google Assistant, Siri, and Alexa or Cortana. So these are can just hear to you and respond to you. So nowadays, what is happening? No, nowadays what the AIs are made, that they can hear you and they can respond to you. But still it is a limitations that they are having no intelligence. Next one is dependence on power. A computer is an electronic machine, thus its dependence on power makes it costly. Yes, see, like, we need rest, we can get bored, so sometime we need rest, we can become weak, so also sometime we need rest. So if you're not having power, no, like kuch systems hote hain, aapne plug kiya, they will work. आजकल के लैपटॉप्स होते हैं, बैटरी पर वर्क करते हैं. बट देन ऑल्सो इफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इज नॉट देयर, सो यू कैन नॉट ऑपरेट योर सिस्टम. सपोज फॉर 2 to 3 days इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इज नॉट देयर, सो व्हाट विल हैपन? वी कैन नॉट यूज आवर कंप्यूटर सिस्टम्स. सो बेनिफिट्स के साथ इसके कुछ लिमिटेशंस भी हैं, लाइक इनकैपेबिलिटी टू थिंक, नो इंटेलिजेंस, डिपेंडेंस ऑन पावर. सो दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट टूडे. नाउ वी आर कंप्लीटिंग आवर चैप्टर 1. So chapter 2 we will study from our next class.